So we're going to go over to our Delineate Subbasins command, and we're going to define, you know, we want it to delineate the watershed based on our terrain surface, whatever it is. So we're not going to use everything. I don't want to boil the ocean here. So I'm going to come in here and just define my limits. So I'm going to click on the pick button and just draw a box around the area that I want to consider. So I'm just looking at that area right there. And so it'll crop my DEM down to just this area. And then I want to utilize the original terrain data. So in this case, it's a 3 meter DEM. So just hit next and it clips it for us. And it smooths it, does some smoothing there. And the next part is it's going to figure out where the streams are. Now, if you're dealing in urban areas, like I, for example, I have a client down in Dallas, and he's using this for residential subdivisions, and it's fairly flat in Dallas. You saw all the flooding that happened this past week, that past weekend down there. And so what happens down there is they've got culverts, they got ditches, and that doesn't necessarily always show up in the terrain model. So what he does there is then he goes and manually draws in where the culvert is, or he can actually select them. He can pick where the culverts are, and it burns those into the terrain model so it's accurately represented in those urban environments. Now, we're not, we got some culverts to worry about here, but we don't need to worry about it. The software will figure out a best guess where the culvert location is, but we don't need to worry about that. It'll take care of that, unless it's super flat. If it's super flat like Dallas, then you got to go and draw them in or select them. So we'll just click on next, and it goes through that process. And by the way, all these computations you see here run 10 times faster than on normal software programs because we're running on a graphics card. Your graphics card has actually been optimized for video gaming. That's what the graphics card manufacturers do, right? Their big market is video games, right? And the thing is, it's really fast at doing processing of terrain data. So all the terrain data processing, we don't rely on the Intel chip. We're using your NVIDIA chip or whatever graphics card chip you're using. We'll fail over to the standard CPU chip if you don't have a graphics card capable of doing it. But if you're running AutoCAD, you've got a graphics card that can do it. And so things run much, much quicker here. All right, so next thing we want to do is figure out how big a drainage area do we want to deal with here. Now you can kind of play with that number, but the smaller the number, the smaller subbasins you have. So if you're working in urban areas, you're going to have an area of maybe 5 contributing acres or something like that. In this case, we've got a pretty big area, so I'm going to put in 500 acres. And if you don't like it, you can redo it, right? And I'm going to manually place where I want to have the subbasins be. So I'm going to go in here, manually put in my outlets. So I'm going to click on draw, and I'm going to place an outlet. Let me turn off the watershed layer here. I want to place an outlet right where that culvert entrance is. And then I'm going to follow the stream up where it kind of drew this originally. And I can zoom in here, and you can see there's another culvert here. And you can see the difference that a 10 meter DEM takes, right? So there's like 30 feet there, or maybe more, that the stream's misaligned. Right. So, but we know that the stream should be there. Now here's another case where it's going to, you know, there's going to have to be a culvert in there, but it'll figure that out on its own. But if you're working in Dallas, you'd want to draw that culvert in. Otherwise, it's going to like maybe go a different direction. It won't know that, hey, you know, because it's seeing what the terrain is doing there. So we're going to keep following.
So go ahead, Chris. Just 1 second. So the program itself is actually going to be putting those conveyance structures in there, the way I understand that, unless you're in a real flat territory where you need to draw in where those locations are at.
That's right, exactly, exactly.
So it's more of a matter of QC after you, just like any model, build your first working copy.
Right.
And then as you go through your troubleshooting, then you draw it in if something's not looking correct.
Exactly. And you can iterate on it. So, you know, if you don't like it, you don't have to throw all your work away. Like in hec-hms, you're kind of like, I don't know. Or GIS, you're kind of like, I don't know, I got to start again. Here you just go back and start again. You start where you need to start. You don't need to start from ground zero. Okay, so we got another culvert up here. And so I can see that guy located right there. And then I'm going to look at one more up here. There's one sitting, let's see, 2 barrels right there. So we'll pop it in there. So at this point, I'm pretty much done. So I just right click, say done, and then just hit next, and it finishes up. So it's going to do all that. You can do this with other software programs. You can do this ArcGIS. You can probably do it in InfoSwim or whatever. But it's like, you know, a 30-minute process, and then it's like, oops, it didn't quite work. This is like 3 minutes. Because like I said, this is running on your graphics card, so it's significantly faster. Now at this point, this is GIS data. So if you wanted to put this into InfoSwim, we could say, okay, what is that? I can see it's actually a polygon, and it's got all of the different hydrologic parameters associated to it. Now, I didn't turn on all the calculations, so it just has some basic hydrologic calcs here. But I could turn on the other things, but a lot of people don't use, like, you know, where's the centroid and what's the longest distance through the centroid. So a lot of people don't use those calcs, and it just adds computation time. So at this point, though, we can also look at the stream. So you can see where the the USGS NHD Plus, whatever it's called, where it thought the stream was, and you can see where, based on the terrain data, where our stream is. So you can see it's coming up much more accurate. And you can also go back in and turn on the watershed, and you can see, okay, you can see how much smoothing, how much more accurate it is in certain areas here. But at this